سنتي، ما قال النبي هو الصحيح، نكاح مبارك مبارك.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome, brothers and sisters, to another episode in the series Marriage and Divorce. With me here is our Sheikh Haitham Al Haddad, who is based in the UK and is part of the Islamic Sharia Council of Britain. In this episode, we hope to expand on the topic of marriage websites. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Marriage websites these days, are you finding that it's becoming an avenue that people are starting to use more when it comes to looking for a spouse?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillah. Yes, this is now a common way that is used by many people, whether in Muslim countries and non-Muslim countries, to look for a potential spouse. In fact, both the men, they will look for potential wives, and the sisters will look for potential men. And sometimes even the families are using those websites. So it is a common practice now. See, we cannot stop it because it has some maybe Shari'i implications. We cannot stop it. It started to be common practice. And by the way, for many people, they don't have other avenues other than using websites. I'll give you an example. A revert brother or a revert sister, her family or his family are not Muslims. And if they were to look for him, yeah, for a potential spouse, they will not do that. Or they will look for an un-Muslim lady or an un-Muslim man. This is one thing. The other thing is, you know, in the West, I'm talking about the West, I'm not talking about other countries, normally, non-Muslim families don't have social networks. No. This issue of cousins and uncles and, you know, extended family, it is not there in their culture. So if, for example, a revert brother, even if his family reverted to Islam, he wouldn't go to his mother and tell her, use our extended family to find a potential why for me? It is not practical, it is not the case. So in this case, what is this brother going to do? Now, in many non-Muslim countries, those young brothers and sisters, they go to either the websites or they go to mosques or to some Islamic marriage bureaus or to some Islamic marriage events. So they have a number of choices. They go to the Islamic center or the mosque, they go to the Islamic marriage events, or they go to the websites, or sometimes they go to their friends. They use their friends. Using their friends is a good choice. Using the families of their friends is a good choice. And by the way, as we are discussing this, it will be highly recommended for any person who converted to Islam to build a social network around him. So his Muslim friends, and to have some kind of connection with the Muslim families in general. So he will not be isolated or she will not be isolated. And to use that network, okay? If that doesn't happen or it did not work for whatever reason, then they can use websites, marriage websites, Islamic marriage websites, or they can use events. You know, what do we mean by events? You know, in Britain, for example, some brothers and sisters, they have organizations to help others to get married. In those organizations, they arrange events. Now we need to talk about the Shari'i aspects of those events, because some of those events are totally un-Islamic. Totally un-Islamic. How do they work? I came across some events. The brothers did describe some events. They say they hire a hall, or they hire a hotel, or a hall in a hotel. And they sit, the brothers and the sisters. Yeah? Then the managers of the event, they group the brothers and the sisters based on the previous data.
Okay.
Two groups. And each group have some common qualities among them based on the applications they filled previously. So a group of brothers and sisters, they will sit together, 10 of them. 5 brothers, 5 sisters, or something like this. And they will start discussing marriage and their future and what they are looking for and the potential spouse. They will discuss it for an hour or so. This is what happens and what I've been told that happens in some of those events. Then the brother will like one of the sisters. Yeah? And he will feel that there is a match between him and her. So he will tell her, what do you think, sister, of having me as a husband? And she said, well, yeah, you look nice. I will accept you. And then they will go and complete the procedure. Now, this is un-Islamic. Why it is un-Islamic? Because, first of all, there is a casual discussion between a group of men and women. If I am interested in a sister, as we will see, I should speak to her wali, first of all.
Exactly.
Okay? I should not just look and socialize with 5 sisters or with 10 sisters, and then I choose one of them in this way. No, this is not acceptable. Those girls whom I want to choose from them, they are not mahram from me. Where is قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ, say to the believers to lower their gaze. Where is this when I'm looking and casually discussing with all these girls?
Especially if you're there with the intention of marriage, you're going to look in a different way.
Exactly, yes. Yes, that is the case. And normally there will be some very maybe flirting and passing comments and these things. And the absurd issue with this scenario is that all of us will be discussing it together.
It's strange.
Okay, anyway, this is not Islamic. This is not Islamic. Some events, they take the details of the brothers and sisters, and they study those details, they study those applications, and they match themselves. Yeah? And then they say to this brother, go to this sister, and you discuss it. Look at her, she looks at you. Now, if this is done under the supervision of the wali, it might be acceptable. Okay? Why we need the wali? Because who is the wali? The wali is the person in charge of the sister. The wali is the male who is responsible for the sister, in charge of this sister.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? If the wali is there and he approved this process, okay, and he approved this potential proposal, then that can be acceptable, provided that the other shari'i issues are also observed. So this is an example of other events. I heard that, I don't want to mention the country, again, a non-Muslim country, but the Muslims there are a bit, as they say, advanced. Yeah? And there is no specific organization that carry out a certain procedure. All what they have some Islamic events, some Islamic lectures, seminars. Part of that event is the brothers who are interested to marry with the sisters. Yeah, they meet in a big hall, casually. Maybe 50 of them, 100 of them, and they just meet. And, okay, the brother is sitting, and the sisters are sitting, and the other brothers are sitting. So I will just look and I will see this sister talking to this brother. I will go to her, or I will see her. No one is around her. I will tell her, my name is Haytham al-Haddad. I'm interested in marriage. Can we sit and discuss this issue? No, no, seriously, this is what happens. I've been told that this happens in some, I don't want to mention the country, and I don't want to mention the name of the organization that normally facilitates something like this. Yeah? Even I was told by one of the du'at who used to speak in such events, he said, it is known that by the end of this 2 days or 3 days event, that brothers who want to marry, they go to that hall, and the sisters, they go to the same hall. No parents are allowed. This became a norm. And he said, sometimes we have to just to accept it because this is the only avenue for brothers and sisters to get married. This is very strange for me. This is totally un-Islamic. Yeah? There is no justification to say that they are living in a non-Muslim country, there are no avenues for them to get married, etc., etc., because all the rules regarding Sharia, lowering the gaze, not having free mixing, the wali issue, the presence of the wali consent, okay? All these issues have been violated in such events or such scenarios. So this is, again, not acceptable.
SubhanAllah. JazakAllah, Ya Sheikh. We will continue this discussion after the break, inshallah. Please do come back, brothers and sisters, where we can find out more details, specifically on the website issue when it comes to looking for a potential spouse. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
A friendly message by Dr. Zakir. Islam prohibits killing of innocent human beings.
Every day, innocent human beings are being killed in different parts of the world. Most religions condemn the killing of innocent human beings. But Islam goes a step further and says in the glorious Quran, Surah Al-Ma'idah, chapter number 5, verse number 32, if anyone kills a human being, unless it be for murder or for spreading corruption in the land, it would be as if he has killed the whole of humankind. It does not stop here, but continues. And if anyone saved a single human life, it would be as if he has saved the life of the entire humankind. Remember, please do not kill a single innocent human being, but rather save the whole of humankind by saving human lives.
Human life is precious. Beast TV, the solution for humanity.
Most countries of the world ban bullying. They fight it in their schools and universities. A lot of us are being bullied differently every single day. Some come up to us and say, do this, while others say, don't you dare. Some say this is halal, while others say, nope, this is haram. Are you confused? Do you feel lost? Join me in Umdat al-Ahkam, where, with the grace of Allah, we will learn the proper knowledge from the Quran and from the Sunnah, which would help stop this kind of bullying.
Join Asim al-Hakim in Umdat al-Ahkam, next on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome, brothers and sisters, to this discussion where we have started the topic on using specific websites and when it comes to searching for a spouse. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
You were just saying regarding websites and events and how certain things these days are happening but are not Islamic.
Yeah. So we explained how some events are run, and we said that such events are un-Islamic. So what is the acceptable event or marriage event that can take place? First of all, the key thing is no gazing. Yeah? Mm. No gazing. That the brother is gazing among many sisters all at once, and the sisters are present in front of the brothers all at once.
It's like a shop.
It is like a shop. Now, see, some, unfortunately, speakers said, Ya akhi, okay, if you go to the marketplace, you will see many sisters all at once. There is a difference between you go to the market, your intention is going to the market, not to look at women. If you go to the market with the intention to look at women or to the opposite gender, then that is haram. And imagine that you are going to choose a sister. Will you go with يعني, a perfect desire? Will you go with an element of a sexual desire or what? Definitely, no man will say that I'm going to a marriage bureau where I'm going to see 20 or 30 sisters all at once and without a shadow of a doubt that those sisters are coming and beautifying themselves.
Of course, of course.
Is this acceptable? Subhanallah, where is lowering the gaze? قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. And then Allah Jalla Ala said, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنَّ وَيَحْفَظْنَ فُرُوجَهُنَّ وَلَا يُبْدِينَ زِينَتَهُنَّ. They should not show and present their zina. Their zina is anything that beautifies them. This is zina, adornments. Anything that beautifies them. Any kind of makeup, any kind of kuhul, even sometimes colored clothes. Yeah? Colored hijab makes the sister more attractive than non-colored hijab. Is that true or not?
It's true.
We see this. I'm not talking about face, aura, it is not aura. Because if we talk about these issues, then they will say, well, the face is not aura. The woman is not obliged to cover her face, so it is acceptable. No, if the woman is not obliged to cover her face, it doesn't mean that she will wear makeup.
Exactly.
It doesn't mean that she can display herself in front of other men. It doesn't mean that she comes in front of the camera and hundreds of thousands of people are gazing at her.
But then, Sheikh, to challenge that, in terms of intention, some people would say, but they're going there with the intention to get married.
To get married to who? To those 20? To one. Yeah?
Yeah.
And it is allowed to look at a specific one for marriage. Not to look here, 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 and as a show of women. Come on.
It's disrespectful to the sisters also.
Again, yeah, again. And imagine, would sisters, when they are coming for a proposal like this, will they come with abaya, with very loose clothes, non-attractive clothes? Will they behave in a very modest way? Or they are going to...
try to get the attention
to get the attention. They will act as models, yeah? But with some Islamic clothes, yeah? Models presenting themselves, subhanAllah. This is not acceptable. No one, I doubt that there would be any scholar who would say that this kind of event, yeah, or events are acceptable, okay? It violates many basic Islamic Sharia rulings. So what are the acceptable events? As we said, the wali has to be there. The man should look for a specific woman.
No gazing.
No gazing. That can be pre-arranged through the event managers. Yeah? That can be arranged. There is no problem if the man might say, well, okay, I might see 2-3 sisters. That can be acceptable. But not just to see 20. Yeah? And to look at them all at once. So, again, this has to be observed. Sisters should not come with makeup. Yeah? That is not allowed as well. And, as I said, one person is interested in another specific person. Now, these are events that can be acceptable from an Islamic Sharia perspective.
In terms of getting back to the issue of websites now.
Yeah.
I suppose we don't want to go too detailed in terms of the fiqh issues.
Yeah.
But we have to highlight it a little bit because this is something that's going on.
Yeah, now see, the issue of websites, a lot of discussion has to be said about this. Because first of all, those brothers and sisters who run websites, yeah, they have to observe many Sharia rulings regarding having websites like this. Okay, and I have been involved in some discussions related to building websites that facilitate marriage. Number of things have to be put into consideration. First of all, the issue of the details of the people. They have to deal with them in top confidentiality. Yeah? And those details should not be exposed to a large number of people, even from the people in charge of the website.
There's no need.
There is no need, because these are some personal information. Yeah? And sometimes the details might encourage those in charge of the websites to propose to those people, or this will create fitna, or even this will create kind of desire. And we knew that there were certain circumstances where the people, where the brothers and the sisters in charge of the websites, they were interested in some of those who have passed the details. There is another problem, which is that the Prophet ﷺ prohibited a woman, yeah, to describe another woman in details to her husband as if he is seeing her. Yeah, this is an authentic hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari reported by Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. لا تنعت المرأة المرأة لزوجها كأنه يراها. A woman should not describe another woman to her husband as if he is seeing her. Why? Because, ya akhi, men by nature, they might sexually, okay.
It might come to their mind.
Yeah, it might come to their mind.
Yeah.
So, is it allowed for men to read these details? Is it allowed for brothers to read these details? Yeah. Especially if they know the person, exactly, or they know the family. This is a shara'i problem. Mm. This is a big shara'i problem. On the other side, is it allowed for the sister to read the details of the brother? Yeah, he is tall, he is smart, he is a big body, he is looking for a potential spouse who is loving and caring, and he has a loving and caring nature. Is it allowed to read this? This is a shara'i problem. Mm-hmm. Now, if the websites have the ability to hide this information, so the people in charge of the website don't read those details, maybe.
So if the information is restricted?
If the information is restricted, see, is restricted to the people in charge of the website. Mm. If they can find a way, then it's all right. Okay? If hypothetically. This is one thing. The other thing is the issue of pictures, photos. I know that many sisters now are easy and flexible or relaxed with the issue of their photos being taken or put online. Mm. Yeah? And this is a huge problem. Unfortunately, the sisters are using the fiqhi issue regarding the permissibility of uncovering the face as a basis for them to put their pictures online or on TV or something like this. Then they will go one step further. Have you ever seen a sister, yeah, putting her picture or coming on TV and she is looking angry or looking normal? Normally she smiles.
Mm. Yeah, she tries to beautify herself.
She tries to beautify herself. Or the nature of, you know, this social media and pictures. You didn't go and have a photo of yourself and you are angry and you show your features. You are angry or even normal. You will try to smile. Even they say when you have a photo, say cheese in order to just to force yourself to smile.
To smile.
Agree or not?
Agree.
So, is this acceptable? Forget about the face, aura or not aura. This is one element. And the other element, is it acceptable that the sister, yeah, to put her face where thousands of people are going to gaze at her?
Exactly.
Where is قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ? Where is when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Ali ibn Abi Talib, the first glance is for you, but not the second one, which means that if I look at a woman, I should not look again and again and again. The issue of necessity is something else. Mm. Okay? I should not look again and again. And the issue of proposal, the khitbah, is something else because I decided to go for this sister. So I'm thinking about a sister called Salwa, the daughter of Saeed. So that particular sister, I'm allowed to look at her.
Because your intention is marriage and you specifically
exactly
that sister.
Exactly, because I have an intention to get married to her. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Unzur ilayha." Yeah? He said, look at her, a specific lady.
Single. Mm.
Okay? Not look at all women and choose among them. Okay? Yes.
Jazakallah khair, Sheikh. I think we'll have to come back or possibly extend this talk into a new episode because there is so much to talk about, especially because it is to do with modern technology. This is a new issue, so we need to talk about more details, especially maybe the fiqh side of things, to see what permissibility is in terms of searching for marriage and a potential spouse through marriage websites. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. مبارك مبارك زواج مبارك مبارك النكاح من سنتي ما قال النبي هو الصحيح نكاح مبارك مبارك There is joy, there is happiness. In this union, let there always be peace. Allah will bless your home with light, your heart with never-ending delight. Two worlds today have now become one.